Natural Learning with me. Today, let's proceed to the second phase of my discussion for emerging technology for classroom instruction and virtual classroom phase two. Now, we will be talking about artificial intelligence, machine learning, and virtual reality. And we will be talking about the application or softwares that can be used in education that uses artificial intelligence, machine learning, and as well as virtual reality. You're gonna love this one. Stay tuned. A recent market report predicts that global AI in the education market will reach up to $3.68 billion by 2023. And this technology enables more exciting and innovative teaching methods and learning experiences. That is why many foreign schools are now using artificial intelligence, augmented reality, virtual reality in teaching. But the question there is, what is artificial intelligence? AI is the technique of programming a computer to respond to data in the same way an intelligent being does. That's according to Lawrence Morini. He is a lead advocate of Google for AI. But what is AI-powered education? The connection between AI and education involves three areas according to UNESCO. The first one is learning with AI. That talks about the use of AI-powered tools in the classroom. The second one is learning about AI. That talks about its technologies and techniques. And the last one, or the third one, is preparing for AI. That's enabling all citizens to better understand the impact or the potential impact of AI on human life. Applications of artificial intelligence or AI in education. Artificial intelligence has helped increase productivity among faculties and help them concentrate more on students than doing the office work or than doing administrative work. And one of the most promising applications of using AI in education is in automating activities such as grading. It can be tedious for teachers to do that. But AI can grade multiple types of questions and also fill in the blanks without an educator's involvement. So that means it frees up time for teachers and enables them to focus more on other priorities. Administrative tasks automated to aid educators. Artificial intelligence or AI can help educators with non-educational tasks, like tasks related duties such as facilitating and automating personalized messages towards their students, back office tasks such as grading paperwork, arranging and facilitating parents and guardian interactions, routine issue feedback facilitating, managing enrollment, courses, and other HR-related topics. Another one is creating smart content. Digitization of content like video lectures, conferences, and textbook guides can be made using AI. We can apply different interfaces like animations and learning content for customization for students from different grades. Artificial intelligence helps create a rich learning experience by generating and providing audio and video summaries and integral lesson plans. Another one is voice assistance. Without even the direct involvement of the lecturer or the teacher, a student can have access or can access extra learning material or assistance through voice assistance. And through this, printing costs of temporary handbooks and also provide answers to very common questions easily. Another one is personalized learning. Using AI technology, hyper-personalization techniques can be used to monitor students' data thoroughly, including habits, lesson plans, reminders, study guides, flash notes, frequency of revision, etc. can be easily generated. Another one is due tutoring. Continuously evolving personal study programs take into account students' gaps to fill during individual lessons. Personal tutoring and support for the students outside of the classroom helps learners keep up with the course and keep their parents from struggling to explain algebra and other complex topics to their kids. AI tutors are great time savers for the teachers, as they do not need to spend extra time explaining challenging topics to students. So that means with AI-powered chatbots, for instance, or AI virtual personal assistant, students can avoid being embarrassed by asking for additional help in front of their friends or classmates. Another one is ensure access to education for students with special needs. Yes, not only for normal or regular students, AI also a great help to those persons or students with special needs or those with disabilities. The adoption of innovative AI technologies open up new ways of interacting for students with learning disabilities. AI grants access to education for students who are deaf and hard of hearing, visually impaired, or people with ADHD. With AI, we experience less pressure, right? Lessons tailored to the needs of different learning groups allow students to stop comparing them to each other. Before, usually a student would normally ask the teacher in front of the class to ask some help in front of their classmate. Now, not anymore. There is an option for them to type a query using a personal virtual assistant and get an instant explanation. And these opportunities offered by AI tools make personal progress come to the core, reducing less pressure in the classroom. Less pressure means less stress and more enthusiasm in teaching and learning. It is no surprise that the AI market develops rapidly with a 54% growth in the global market in 2019. While in 2018 before, the overall market revenue of AI software has reached $10.1 billion. Imagine that, and the best part is that you can use AI-powered apps today. Of course, everyone heard about Siri, Cortana, and Alexa, but there are also several tons of magnificent AI-powered apps that are on stream right now. The best part, or the most beautiful thing, is that AI brings 24/7 access to learning resources for teachers and lessons anytime, anywhere. AI can be used as an educational tool that guides students towards their goals by providing them personalized feedback on homework, quizzes, and etc. According to experts, there are three types of AI: weak or narrow AI, the second one is strong AI, and the third one is super AI or conscious AI. When you say weak AI, it can perform a specific task, but not to learn new ones, nor interact, unlike strong and super AI can. Weak AI is applied to specific domains such as language translators, virtual assistants, AI-powered apps, web search engines, self-driving cars, recommendation engines, intelligent spam folders, and so much more. That's where we come in with AI-powered educational apps. Whereas strong AI, it can learn new tasks to solve new problems, and it does this by teaching itself with new strategies. Generalized intelligence is a combination of many AI strategies that learn from experience and can perform at a human-level intelligence. Lastly, on the other hand, super AI, or also called as conscious AI, is AI with human-level consciousness, which would require to be self-aware. Because we are not yet able to adequately define what consciousness is, it is unlikely that we will be able to create a conscious AI in the near future. This AI definition was adopted from IBM's Artificial Intelligence Framework. But in general, AI means different things for different people. For instance, for a video game designer, AI means writing code that affects how bots play or how the environment reacts to a player. Whereas for a screenwriter, AI means a software that can identify the best structure and vocabulary to use, which can be a time-consuming process for copywriters. It also provides them with new ideas on what they should write about. While for data scientists, AI is a way of exploring and classifying data to meet specific goals. See the list of AI softwares on the next page and how to get started. Ready? So let me introduce the Artificial Intelligence 2022 state-of-the-art applications and softwares. Let's start with the chatbot called DataBot. DataBot is an AI-powered virtual assistant, and it's available on Windows 10, Android, and iOS. It's also available on Xbox One, iPad and iPod, Android tablets, and Windows phones, and this app answers your questions in its voice, and it addresses the topics that matter to you, so it's very useful also for teachers. DataBot has services integrated within it that provide you with images, information, and multimedia presentations based on the topic of your choice. It uses Google searches, Wikipedia, RSS channels, etc. to provide you with the information that you might need. You can also customize DataBot according to your preference of language, voice, etc. DataBot can speak and understand English, Italian, Spanish, and others. And how to use DataBot? Just download the DataBot from your iOS or Play Store. And once you're ready to log in, just click on the Start button and pick from any options available and enjoy. Watch this.
In this very helpful app, you'll find everything you need wrapped up in one stylish program. With DataBot, you'll be able to have a fun voice assistant as well as a reference for anything all in your pocket. DataBot will find answers to all your questions by scanning major search engines for you, saving you lots of time. With all types of modules to use within the app, you'll find that it's the perfect app for almost every task. With the thematic module, you'll find about famous people, fictional characters, movies, sports teams, and more. There's also a news section of the app where you can read all the latest on whatever topics pique your interest, from politics to pop culture and beyond. You can even chat with your bot and use it for all sorts of funny jokes. With endless ways to use the app, you'll find out that DataBot is much more than just a personal assistant.
I would rather share one lifetime with you than face all the ages of this world alone.
In addition to all the utility you get from the DataBot app, there's also tons of fun to be had with this versatile personal assistant. You can rack up experience points playing games with DataBot, like the Brain Train Tournament. And be sure to enjoy the Riddle module as you test your wit and skill with all sorts of puzzles from math to logic riddles. You can also earn experience points by giving commands to your personal assistant. You can unlock new features and content in the store to complete additional tasks and find hours of new ways to have fun and be informed. One of the most useful and appreciated features in DataBot is the ability to make multimedia presentations using voice, text, and images. The app is able to quickly identify almost anything, and with a dictionary module paired with the ability to search, you can find the answers to what you're looking for in the blink of an eye. With all the useful features DataBot provides, it can also be highly personalized. DataBot has the ability to understand your language and understands practically all major languages for that matter. The more you speak with DataBot, the more it learns from you and learns how to better serve you. You can change your personal assistant's name, voice, and even behavior in order to fit your desires.
Nice to meet you, human. My name is DataBot. I am a protocol droid programmed to serve you.
The DataBot team has constantly been working to release new upgrades and features. And now the app is available across all platforms for iOS, Android, Windows, and even Xbox One. With all the amazing capabilities DataBot has to offer, you'll want to start using it for everything you do.
Now let's have a short quiz.
What is DataBot? Interactive quiz app. Talking virtual bot app. A talking machine. Talking cat. On which device / S that DataBot is compatible with? Android devices. Laptop and desktop. iPad and iPod. All of the above. How would to use DataBot? Tap Settings. Tap Start. Tap Customize. Tap Upgrades. DataBot is best for providing users with all of the above. Presentations. Riddles. Searches. what button to click to activate speak command. Ellipses. Keyboard. Microphone. Question mark.
Let's have a minute break. Now, let's proceed to another app called Simplify. It's an all-in-one digital design platform that helps you create content in a simpler way. So, video editing is complicated, but through Simplify, it was made simpler. Sounds interesting? You have tons of templates to choose from, and those are free. You have video templates to pick, to choose from that you can adjust in every dimension. Or you can get one. You can customize it with premium stock videos that they have in the library. You can drag and drop it and adjust and add and adjust it easily. Keep it simple with just one click presets. And this is how it looks. It is somehow similar to Canva, or you can customize every detail. Everything that you add can be customized. You can add music. You can upload your own MP3. Or you can pick one from the library. You can send your link to invite other people for real-time editing to collaborate instantly with your team. Sounds creative, right? Everything you need is already here with Simplified. And for a free version, you can have 5 members or 5 people in one account. Alright, so how to start? Just go to the browser and type in simplify.com and click on sign up with Google. Or you may fill in email, password, confirm your password, and click on sign up with Google. And you would have this.
AI design generator, AI document the editor, or you can start with a template. And this is the homepage. So once you're able to log in, you will see that homepage and you will see the tons of beautiful templates that you can pick, whether it's for Instagram posts, social media banners, skyscrapers, that's for ads, even for ebook covers templates, and even for blog posts. Yes, for Simplified, you can make a short blog. And here are my projects that I created through Simplified. And this is for the blog and the banner. And this is for the video templates I picked that I just edited on their app, on their software. How to write a blog using Simplified?
Generate entire blogs, long articles, and essays in minutes with our long-form writer. You can find it by clicking AI Assistant to your left, and then by clicking on Launch Writer. Let's use AI to write a blog. We'll start by generating blog ideas and titles from the drop-down menu. And then we'll click Generate. And here are some great titles to get our blog off to a good start. You can click the plus or add now button to drop your favorite output right onto the document. Now let's go ahead and hook our audience with an engaging introduction. Now here's the cool part. You can go back to your document and just highlight the title to give Simplified's AI something to work with. Then let's sit back and watch Loki create an entire paragraph in one click. Now let's go ahead and generate a cohesive outline for our blog. Now I can generate content even quicker by highlighting each subpoint, and our shortcut menu will pop up. I can just click Write Section, and it's going to automatically complete that section of my blog for me. Now, if there's a sentence or paragraph that's just not cutting it for you, you can simply highlight it and select rewrite from the shortcut menu. And the AI will generate that same sentiment with different words. Every good copywriter knows you need to end with a clear call to action. So to wrap things up, select blog conclusion paragraph from the drop-down menu, and then we'll put in our overarching blog topic and our desired call to action. Click generate. And there you have it. A clear call to action to make sure that your audience knows exactly what to do.
Let's have a short break.
The whispers in the morning of love asleep and tired are rolling by like thunder now as I look in your eyes.
And DALL E2 are machine learning models developed by OpenAI to generate digital images from natural language descriptions. When we say natural language description, it's an English text. DALL E was revealed by OpenAI in a blog post in January 2021 and uses a version of GPT-3 modified to generate images. DALL E is a 12 billion parameter version of GPT-3 trained to generate images from text descriptions using a dataset of text-image pairs. And DALL E for creating images from text, how to start? Just check the link for the step-by-step guide on how to register for OpenAI or DALL E 2. Watch this.
Have you ever seen a polar bear playing bass? Or a robot painted like a Picasso? Didn't think so. DALL E 2 is a new AI system from OpenAI that can take simple text descriptions like a koala dunking a basketball and turn them into photorealistic images that have never existed before. DALL E 2 can also realistically edit and retouch photos. Based on a simple natural language description, it can fill in or replace part of an image with AI-generated imagery that blends seamlessly with the original. It's called inpainting. In January 2021, OpenAI introduced DALL E, a system that could generate images from text, like this avocado armchair. DALL E 2 takes the technology even further with higher resolution, greater comprehension, and new capabilities, like in painting. It can even start with an image as an input and create variations with different angles and styles. DALL E was created by training a neural network on images and their text descriptions. Through deep learning, it not only understands individual objects, like koala bears and motorcycles, but learns from relationships between objects. And when you ask DALL E for an image of a koala bear riding a motorcycle, it knows how to create that or anything else with a relationship to another object or action. The DALL E research has three main outcomes. First, it can help people express themselves visually in ways they may not have been able to before. Second, an AI-generated image can tell us a lot about whether the system understands us or is just repeating what it's been taught. Third, DALL E helps humans understand how AI systems see and understand our world. This is a critical part of developing AI that's useful and safe. The technology is constantly evolving, and DALL E 2 has limitations. If it's taught with images that are incorrectly labeled, like a plane labeled car, and a user tries to generate a car, DALL E may create a plane. It's like talking to a person who learned the wrong word for something. DALL E can also be limited by gaps in its training. If you type baboon and DALL E has learned what a baboon is through images and accurate labels, it will generate a lot of great baboons. But if you type howler monkey and it hasn't learned what a howler monkey is, DALL E will give you its best idea of what it thinks it could be, like a howling monkey. What's exciting about the approach used to train DALL E is that it can take what it learned from a variety of other labeled images and then apply it to a new image. Given a picture of a monkey, DALL E can infer what it would look like doing something it's never done before, like paying its taxes while wearing a funny hat. DALL-E is an example of how imaginative humans and clever systems can work together to make new things, amplifying our creative potential.
So the next thing that you must do is to sign up for DALL-E. All you have to do is go to the browser, better yet, use your laptop or computer to access the desktop version, because there will be a lot of available features, most especially the new feature of DALL-E, which is out paintings. It's very creative and it's perfect for those artists. Alright, so all you have to do, again, go to the browser, type in openai.com, just click on the button, join waitlist, there will be a pop-up box. So all you have to do is enter your email address, confirm it, enter the code, and wait for the email confirmation that you have requested an access. After a week or two, you will be receiving another email confirming that you were granted an access for DALL-E. Then just follow the prompts on the instructions included in your email confirmation, and after which you will be receiving 50 free credits that replenishes every month. So you will be able to generate image for free. That's one image is equal to one credit. After a month, it will replenishes again for another 50 free credits. So it's enough for you to explore your creativity by typing in any text input that you would like DALL-E to generate image for you. And you might also love to explore other features like their API tool, and as well as the outpainting, the new one. Just use your laptop or your computer and enjoy.
And another thing that OpenAI offers to us is GPT-3. Generative Pre-trained Transformer 3 is an autoregressive language model that uses deep learning to produce human-like text. So give it any text prompt, the API will return a text completion attempting to match the pattern you gave it. You can program it by showing it with just a few examples of what you would like it to do. Its success generally varies depending on how complex the task is. The API also allows you to hone performance on a specific task by training on a dataset, whether it's a small or large examples you provide, or by learning from human feedback provided by the users. So this is an example of a virtual chatbot by OpenAI that uses GPT-3. So in simpler terminology, or in layman terms, it's just a virtual chatbot. I'll be back after a minute while you are exploring. ML is a subset of AI in which a computer can learn how to perform a specific task without being told exactly step by step by humans. And in order for us to understand fully what artificial intelligence is, we must also need to understand what machine learning first. Please watch this.
Picture this, a machine that could organize your cupboard just as you like it, or serve every member of the house a customized cup of coffee. Makes your day easier, doesn't it? These are the products of artificial intelligence. But why use the term artificial intelligence? Well, these machines are artificially incorporated with human-like intelligence to perform tasks as we do. This intelligence is built using complex algorithms and mathematical functions. But AI may not be as obvious as in the previous examples. In fact, AI is used in smartphones, cars, social media feeds, video games, banking, surveillance, and many other aspects of our daily life. The real question is, what does an AI do at its core? Here is a robot we built in our lab, which is now dropped onto a field. In spite of a variation in lighting, landscape, and dimensions of the field, the AI robot must perform as expected. This ability to react appropriately to a new situation is called generalized learning. The robot is now at a crossroad, one that is paved and the other rocky. The robot must determine which path to take based on the circumstances. This portrays the robot's reasoning ability. After a short stroll, the robot now encounters a stream that it cannot swim across. Using the plank provided as an input, the robot is able to cross this stream. So, our robot uses the given input and finds the solution for a problem. This is problem solving. These three capabilities make the robot artificially intelligent. In short, AI provides machines with the capability to adapt, reason, and provide solutions. Well, now that we know what AI is, let's have a look at the two broad categories an AI is classified into. Weak AI, also called narrow AI, focuses solely on one task. For example, AlphaGo is a maestro of the game Go, but you can't expect it to be even remotely good at chess. This makes AlphaGo a weak AI. You might say Alexa is definitely not a weak AI, since it can perform multiple tasks. Well, that's not really true. When you ask Alexa to play Despacito, it picks up the keywords play and Despacito and runs a program it is trained to. Alexa cannot respond to a question it isn't trained to answer. For instance, try asking Alexa the status of traffic from work to home. Alexa cannot provide you this information, as she is not trained to. And that brings us to our second category of AI, strong AI. Now, this is much like the robots that only exist in fiction as of now. Ultron from Avengers is an ideal example of a strong AI. That's because it's self-aware and eventually even develops emotions. This makes the AI's response unpredictable. You must be wondering, well, how is artificial intelligence different from machine learning and deep learning? We saw what AI is. Machine learning is a technique to achieve AI, and deep learning, in turn, is a subset of machine learning. Machine learning provides a machine with the capability to learn from data and experience through algorithms. Deep learning does this learning through ways inspired by the human brain. This means through deep learning, data and patterns can be better perceived. Ray Kurzweil, a well-known futurist, predicts that by the year 2045, we would have robots as smart as humans. This is called the point of singularity. Well, that's not all. In fact, Elon Musk predicts that the human mind and body will be enhanced by AI implants, which would make us partly cyborgs. So, here's a question for you. Which of the below AI projects don't exist yet? A. An AI robot with citizenship. B. A robot with a muscular skeletal system. C. AI that can read its owner's emotions. D. AI that develops emotions over time. Give it a thought and leave your answers in the comment section below. Three lucky winners will receive Amazon gift vouchers. Since the human brain is still a mystery, it's no surprise that AI too has a lot of unventured domains. For now, AI is built to work with humans and make our tasks easier. However, with the maturation of technology, we can only wait and watch what the future of AI holds for us.
And did you know that there is a web-based tool that would make us fast and easy to create machine learning models for your sites, apps, and more? No experience, no expertise required. And that's what we call Teachable Machine. Teachable Machine was created by Google. It's an experiment with Google. Again, it's a web-based tool that helps creating machine model fast and easy and accessible to everyone. So what does it have to do with education? By introducing artificial intelligence and machine learning to those students or people who have never programmed a model before or who don't have a programming or technical background knowledge yet, it will be best to use this Teachable Machine because it's very easy and it's for free. It's accessible by everyone, created by Google. And how it works, please watch this.
Hi, I'm going to show you how to train a model with Teachable Machine. Like all machine learning workflows, you first need to gather data. What you see here on the left are what we call classes. Each of these represents a different category you want to teach the computer to recognize. So let's try adding data to our first class. I'm going to call this one neutral. You have two options here. You can upload files from your local computer or use a webcam. Let's use a webcam. Hit record and I can start collecting images. You can see that I'm moving around here to add variety to my data set. Let's try adding data to our second class. I'm going to call this one dog. Again, I'm going to hit webcam and try to get data from this stuffed animal. You can again see that I'm moving it around to collect some variety. All right, now we have enough data to train this model. Teachable Machine doesn't just work with image data. You can also train an audio model, and the interface looks pretty much the same. One difference is that the data is collected in the form of a spectrogram, which is simply a different way of visualizing audio. Another difference is that you need to record one really long background class, 20 seconds of it to be precise. And finally, all this audio data gets extracted into 1 second samples, like this. So you can make a recognizer that recognizes something short, like clapping, or whistling. Great, now we're ready to train this audio model. And finally, you can use Teachable Machine to create a pose model. Pose estimation is simply a technique for tracking key points on your body so that you can train a model to, say, recognize when your head is tilted left or when your arm is raised. All right, now we have enough data for this model too. One thing to note is that the entire time you're capturing this data, it's staying on device. It's not being sent to any server. So if you want to keep your data, you can either download your samples or save them to Drive. Look out for the next video on how to continue training your model.
And what does it have to do with education then? How can it help us teachers? Teachable Machine is a great tool to use upon introducing AI and ML to beginners. And how? All you gotta do is go to your browser, type in teachablemachine.withgoogle.com. You will have the home screen or the home page like this. All you have to do is click on Get Started. You will have the home page and click on New Project. Another emerging technology is VR, virtual reality. It is the use of computer modeling and simulation that enables a person to interact with an artificial three-dimensional visual or other sensory environment, just like this one. Different types of media have specific ways of conveying human experience, like for example in a podcast, wherein the intimate nature of the medium is to develop a deep connection for the listener, while in virtual reality, it submerges the viewer to an immersive media. This type of media interaction isn't confined to a rectangular or regular rectangular screen. Rather, it creates an illusion by surrounding the viewer with a spatial environment or confined us in a 3D space using spatial computing. I will introduce to you the first web platform for creating, remixing, and sharing volumetric VR using real people and real places through Reach.love. The website name Reach, but you can access that one to the browser by just typing Reach, R-E-A-C-H. .love. Watch this.
Introducing Reach, the first web platform for creating and sharing extended reality content, including augmented and virtual reality, using real people and places. Built by the pioneers at Emblematic Group, Reach is an easy-to-use, browser-based solution that makes the power of walk-around spatial experiences available to anyone. Reach lets you craft your own volumetric stories in three easy steps using a no-code drag-and-drop solution. First, you access a library of 3D locations, many of them captured using stunning high-resolution photogrammetry, You can also upload locations you've created yourself. Then, use our simple tool to add your own real-life video interviews, volumetric characters, or 3D assets. Finally, you can share the results via a simple web link. Embed your finished story just like you would a video. No need for downloads or dedicated apps. Reach eliminates all the distribution barriers facing room-scale VR. Viewers can navigate stories on a smartphone, tablet, or PC, or put on a headset and walk around for full immersion. Sign up now to discover how far you can reach into the future, where the story...
All right, now, coming up to the last topic for today's presentation, this is the last but not the least, this is the 12th topic of my presentation for today, and this is the most sophisticated tool, and this is my most favorite, so if you are like a techie people, or a techie type of person, and loves exploring creativity on every angle, you would love this tool. If only I can have access to this, I can do so much more, and I can create a lot of engaging content. But let's see what this tool has to offer to us. Introducing Tony Stark. Just kidding. This is a tool of Tony Stark featured in Avengers, previously known as Jarvis, but today it was renamed as Jasper. Please watch the features on their videos.
Jasper is equipped with gizmos and gadgets galore. Today, we are going to review some of the basic items you need to know about in order to get familiar with Jasper. In this lesson, I'll show you around the dashboard, where to find templates and documents, as well as your content history, and how to organize it by creating and saving projects. So if you're ready, let's jump in. Inside the app, you'll see a dashboard like this. This will be your home base. You can always access this screen by clicking Dashboard on the nav bar. Inside the dashboard, you'll see areas for different important things. Here you can see announcements for feature updates. This will help you be in the know and up to date on what we've recently launched and what's new inside the app. Over here, you can access your favorite templates. To favorite a template, press the star icon in the top right of any template. This graph will show you how many words you've generated over the last 7 days. And finally, here are a few quick links to the Facebook community and to earning free credits by leaving us an honest review. And right here, you can find the most recent swag shop for Jasper so you can fully express your Jasper self. Our 50 plus templates are the building blocks of Jasper. They are trained to perform very specific use cases and are very simple to understand and use. We'll discuss how to get the most out of them later in bootcamp. You can access the templates by clicking templates on the nav bar, or when you're inside the document, by clicking the power mode icon on the top middle of the screen. Where templates are more constrained, documents allow open-ended content creation in a familiar Google Doc-like experience. Documents are available on the Boss Mode plan. Documents should be used for writing longer content like blog posts, emails, social posts, or even books. You will learn more thoroughly about how to use documents in a later lesson as well. To access documents, click on Documents in the nav bar, and then the plus icon to generate a new document. All content Jasper produces for you is automatically saved to your AI outputs, including any generations inside of a document. There's not currently a way to bulk export content, so the best way to move content out of Jasper is to copy and paste the content like this. Below the AI outputs tab, you have subtabs for outputs that you have favorited or trashed. To favorite a piece of content, simply star it and it will live in the favorites folder and in the general AI outputs folder. Also, as you might imagine, any content that you threw in the trash will live here. Remember, content in the trash gets permanently deleted after 30 days. Projects act as folders for organizing your work. You can create a new project for anything you'd like. Many users create new projects for each client or create separate folders for blog posts, ads, etc. Currently, all users inside your account have access to all the folders in your account. Here's how to create a new project. Click on the project dropdown in the bottom left of the dashboard. Then click the plus icon at the top. Then name the project, and then save it. If you accidentally create content in the wrong project, you can always move it to another project. Let me show you how. To move content to a different project, navigate to the Documents or the AI Outputs tab. Click and drag to highlight the content that you want to move. Then click Move, and finally select the project name that you want to move that content to. Simple enough, that's it for the basics of Jasper. Now you know where to find many of the areas that we'll be referencing in the future lessons of the bootcamp.
Access denied. Access denied. Access granted.
We've done it. We've unlocked Jasper.
Well, if you thought I was just being dramatic for the sake of having a catchy intro sequence, you're only half right, because Jasper really did just launch a new template that unlocks the power of Jasper for all users right inside of a template. That's right, the new Jasper Commands template is as epic as it sounds. You can tell Jasper to write anything inside of this one template, and the results are out of this world. Check it out. The main structure of this template is similar to others. You have two areas for inputs. One allows you to give Jasper context and information about the product, company, event, or whatever else he needs to know about right here. Paste that information into this first area. And the second is where things really get exciting. You can simply type out in plain language instructions for Jasper, just like you would if you were talking to a friend. Generate a negative movie review for Matrix 4, The Matrix Resurrections. And then just hit generate, and look at that. Ooh, hey. Jasper said it, not me. Now imagine the possibilities. You can now use this one template to jumpstart an entire blog post. Like this, write an informative blog post called What Makes a Movie Great? Discuss the different traits a movie needs to be great. What? Look at this output. This is incredible. All of this is inside of one simple template. And with a little information, Jasper can write about any topic, even if it's just made up. Like this, how about a made up movie called Matrix 5, The Rebirth of Neo? Insert some information about it. I'm just going to make up a couple things. And then give a command like this. Write an outline for an outrageous and hilarious movie called Matrix 5, The Rebirth of Neo. Well, there you have it. Another amazing template from Jasper to elevate your creative writing to a whole new level. Jasper understands an infinite amount of commands, so try it out. And for help on thinking up different command ideas, use our Commands Help document, where we share all sorts of commands to use for different use cases. So what are you waiting for? Get started with Jasper today.
And going back, rolling back to the 12 topics that we have discussed for today's presentation, once again, we started with online learning. That's the first one, wherein I have shared with you about MOOC, or Massive Open Online Learning Courses, wherein I have laid out the top 10 MOOC providers. And also, the next one under online learning is nano learning, which is the newest and the most hottest educational teaching delivery of instruction in a smaller inputs, like within 35 minutes or not more than 10 minutes. Through social media, it's because the memory retention of the new generation is kind of short, and they only want to hear and listen to information in just a few minutes. They don't want to listen to a longer one. And the next topic, after the online learning, we have discussed a creation of interactive quizzes. We use the platform Kahoot. All you have to do is go to kahoot.com on the browser, or you can download the app on the Play Store. It's already available, and you'll be able to create your very own interactive quiz. And another one that employs interactive tools is interactive videos. That's the third one, which is third topic, is interactive creation of interactive videos using Edpuzzle. All you have to do is go to the browser, type in edpuzzle.com. And the fourth topic was creation of interactive ebook by just using the book creator. By going to the browser, just type in bookcreator.com, and you'll be able to create your very own ebook. And there's a new update for creating an ebook. You can have 40 books in one library, and every pages of your book, you can have as many pages as you like. And another one is gamification. There are a lot of interactive tools and online learning platforms that offers gamification, or that gamifies learning. Not only that Kahoot provides us creation of interactive quizzes, it also gamifies the learning in the form of games. Like the students learn in the form of the games, that there are points that they accumulated for every correct answer. So it's like fun and interesting than just the dull presentation of quizzes or assessments, the traditional one. And another one, this next one, is creation of video lessons. We use Canva.com for Canva, and another one is Nerpa.com, where I have shared with you, if you love annotating videos, like what Edpuzzle does. You're gonna love their pad because it has the options for us to annotate videos, and even as our learners can also annotate even on top of the PDF files that you share with them online, and you can also conduct an online classes with them just like what Canva for Education has. And you can also provide them interactive quizzes just like what Kahoot app can do for us. And you can also, there is an automating of grades wherein you can get a real-time feedback, a real-time scoring of their assessments during the live discussion and live class. And it's pretty amazing. It's like 3-in-1, 4-in-1, it's only in just 1-2. So you might want to spend your time exploring nearpod.com. It's the best for foreigners, for educators. They love nearpod.com. And they don't have to use multiple tools to get what they want and make their teaching and learning, or transform their teaching and learning into an interactive one compared to the traditional one that we had before. Another one is creation of website. The very easy creation of website is through the use of the platform WordPress.com, wherein it's free, it's open, there's a upgrade version. Like you would have a plugins and other steps like automating sending your subscribers with a message whenever you add some posts. But just for the mere exploring how to create the websites for those who never programmed before and never had any web development course taken, just like me, so it's very easy to use WordPress.com. So there are a lot of features that are being added, so you will also learn that one along the way. And another one is game development for the 8th topic. We have played along with the features of Scratch. I just gave an introduction because it's quite a lot, but there are a lot of videos that I've shared with you, and I also created a blog where there are step-by-step figures, images, step-by-step instructions on how you can make one using the Scratch. All you have to do is just remember the link, or anyway, all of these tools, all of the top fours that we have shared, those top topics that I've discussed are also uploaded in my blog. That's why I attach a QR code for the link of everything, of all the files, wherein there is a PDF file button on my page wherein you can just click on download and you will get everything that I have discussed and shared with you. Another one, after the game development, we have introduced creation of interactive assessments. It's like Kahoot as well, but it's just that if you come to think of creating an interactive assessment, it's like giving them a summative test of 40 to 50 items, which I don't think is suitable to apply or encode in Kahoot. But you can also do so because there's no limit for the number of items for the questions. But for assessing their scores, because we would like to see it all in one page, but through online means or online mode, we can use live worksheets. Live worksheets by going to the website liveworksheets.com, and you will be able to upload your PDF file of the test, because we normally convert our PDF files from docs by creating our test papers on the Microsoft Word and converting it to PDF files so we can download it on our device. And then afterwards, you can upload that PDF file of your assessment test, the literal test papers that you have created or typed in for your learners, and make sure that the size of it will not go beyond 5 MB, because Live Worksheets only allows up to 5 MB. And once you upload it, there will be a box that you can just extend and drag and extend and put the correct answer inside of it. So whenever the students will answer it, there's already a behind the back, there's a correct answer. So it will automatically tell the students if they got the right or the correct answer, the right or the wrong answers for that. So it's very interactive. It's not just answering on the typical form that doesn't have the interactive elements. And you can also browse those freely available that are already made and uploaded on their websites, and it's for free. Another app that employs gamification, aside from brilliant.org, which can be downloaded from the Play Store, there's another one that we can access in the browser, which is learningapps.org. It's like the same as labwatches.com, but I will give the rest for you to explore and see what suits for you. So it applies gamification, it applies interactive assessments, also in one tool. Kumbaga, ginatuhog yung ibang interactive tools in just one or two. Well, one or two characteristics in this one tool, just like your podcast annotated videos, just like with the features of Edpasso. It has the online learning platform, just like what those MMOC platform has. It has interactive pieces like what Kahoot has in just one tool of Nearby. Another one we have discussed, artificial intelligence, which is pretty tacky, and it's, you know, it's a lot of complexities because it's new and we need to learn this, even the basic ones, because our learners, our students, would be dealing with technology, and every day there are a lot of scientists out there, genius people, group of people out there who might be creating something, and there will be another development. Just when I was creating this presentation, another tool came up and I wasn't able to share it because I already crafted my presentation. But there's another one that I would like also to mention, which is video sticker. I know it's quite challenging to take notes out of the video that we usually watch, and if you would like to take notes, you need to pause the video. There would require a number of times to pause the video, screenshot the video, the image, and write it down. Typically, even if we are going to type it in our laptop, it's still tedious and it takes a lot of time. But there's another one that has been created, but there was no confirmed date of release yet, so I'm still confirming it with one of the developer. Hopefully I'll get a response, or hopefully they publish it for everyone to read and everyone get updated if there is a cause for that. But I will surely update or make a post about it. It's what we call the video speakers. What it does is just whatever videos that you will be clicking on, or you will be opening using their platform, video speakers, it extracts all the images from that video presentation, and it even creates a graphic organizer, and it's synchronized according to the timeline, and it's interactive. It's the best. We will be talking about that in the next presentation or the next video clips that I will be sharing. And another one under artificial intelligence, we have discussed, we have talked about DataBot, like five apps there. DataBot, which can be accessible on our smartphones, that can be downloaded from the Play Store or iOS, and it's for free. There is a free version, and if you see the XP, XP is the experience on the platform, and it increases as to how long you're using the app for DataBot. And it's like a Google search, a Google Assistant. It can search the web, it can make presentations for us, it provides images and all the information with its voice. It's very unique because it sounds a robot, like we're talking to a robot, just like it's virtual, it's on the screen. But it's pretty tacky and I love it. It's very easy to navigate, it's user-friendly, and most especially, there are features that I can access for free using just my smartphone. Another one is, we talk about Simplified. We love creating content using Canva, but that can also be accessed and can be made with Simplified. The unique ability or the unique features of Simplified that others don't have is the AI, because Simplified is powered by AI. It's an AI-powered tools that has the capacity or that has the features to create content for you, like introductory ideas for the blog. It can generate the way I presented those short clips from the Simplified staff itself, their very own video introduction of how to use their platform, wherein it can generate ideas for the blogs and it depends on the free version or the plan that you have. But for the free version, you can have 1,000 words per month. It will generate ideas or the topic on top and the paragraph for the content of the blog. So all you gotta do is just copy it and add some text or edit it. So you'll be able to know that once you access the site, just go to the browser and click simplify.com and explore that. So the only difference is the AI, the added feature of AI inside the Simplify. Another one is DALL E, which is very popular. It's image generating platform where it bases the image, it creates an image from the inputs that we enter on how we want or what we are expecting the platform to produce. And now it has added features, which is very exciting for artists, which is what we call outpainting. And another tool, since DALL E was under or created by OpenAI, there are other features, or there are features available other than the DALL E. There is what we call the API tool, which is powered by the virtual chatbot powered by GPT-3. GPT-3 is an autoregressive language, but you don't need to care for the technical terminologies for that. You can just click on API once you already have the access or login. Just follow the steps I laid out in my entire discussion, and you will be able to explore all the features under OpenAI. And it gives you as well, first is 50 free credits, just to correct. And for the succeeding months, it will only be 15 free credits. Another one is what we called, what did we miss? We have Simplified, DataBot, DALL E. We have talked about machine learning, and the best way to introduce artificial intelligence to machine learning, because they are closely related. We cannot teach what artificial intelligence in its entirety without explaining machine learning or without touching the topic about machine learning. That's why they are connected. It's a subset of AI. And one of the tools that uses or that employs machine learning is very easy to navigate, Teachable Machine, which is an experiment of Google that can be accessed by anyone. Just type in Teachable Machine with Google.com. And it's kind of long, but you can see that on the list, so you'll be able to upload. All you have to do is, all you need to have, if you will be creating your model or programming your model using Teachable Machine, are just your prompts, because you will need to create variations now to train your model. Another one is virtual reality, wherein it meets the impossibility with creativity, and the impossibility is like another realm of creative place out there. Like, we can already plan for students' full trip to Mars without having to send them to Mars, actually, or Mars literally, but we can just use or submerge the audience or submerge our learners into an immersive display of how the Mars looks like using virtual reality. And I have introduced to you the first web platform that was created for sharing, remixing volumetric VR using real people and real places through Reach. Or in, all you have to do is go to the browser and type in Reach.love. So once again, to summarize, we have discussed online learning, interactive quiz, interactive videos, gamification, creation of video lessons, creation of interactive assessments, web development, game development, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and virtual reality. And the last but not the least, if I forgot, is one of the app that I hold it as the most sophisticated tool and one of my favorite, my most favorite among the 12 topics I've discussed among all those bunch of tools I have shared is Jasper. And thank you so much for learning with me. Thank you so much for watching the video, and I really appreciate it. I hope that you learned something, and I hope that you will be spending time to explore your creativity and use the tools to see what suits for you. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you.